It's Lynn from Lynn Sea Designs, and today I'm coming on to make a card using the Waterfront stamp set, which is a new one to me, but I made we made this card in class this week, so I'm coming on to make another version of that. I think it's quite nice to have I created this sort of frame. I'd seen some similar cards on Pinterest, as we all do, and decided to give it a go. And I used to make the frame I used two of the oval framelets from the layering oval framelets dies. So I've got the inks Tranquil Tide, Knight of Navy, and Daffodil Delight, just because I'm going to have the sun. I've got some Stampin' Dimensionals and some Tombow liquid glue, and I've got my piercing mats just covered with a bit of the grid paper, because this is a photopolymer stamp set and I always find that's quite helpful to get a better impression. I've got a base which is Tranquil Tide standard A6 card, so 14.9 by 21 scored at 10.5. And then I've got two layers of Whisper White, one for the inside, one for the outside, that are scored at 14.4 by 10 centimetres. I've also got an envelope because, you know, I like to stamp up the envelope. So let's get straight onto it. I'm going to use the Knight of Navy for the mountain range. And I don't want it in full strength just at the moment. First one, second strength, and then I'm going to come in full strength, and then another one there. And then without re-inking, just to try and build up a little bit of a mountain range. There we go. I've got my stamping scrub off to the side so that I can clean my stamps. And then I've got, just want to create a little bit of an edge. So I'm not going to ink up all of this. I'm just going to ink up one edge of the stamp. See if I can't create a little bit of a clean that off. It's a little bit better. There we go. Clear off in between, because otherwise I forget. And then back with the Knight of Navy. For some water, I'm going to stamp off a couple of times, even stamp off three times to start with. One thing I've learnt is you can always go back over. But you can't take the ink off if it's too dark. So that's lovely. It gives me a little bit of a watercolory effect. I'm going to do the sun. Do I want that full strength? No. There we go. Oh, clean that off. Clean that off, and then back with the Tranquil Tide to do some trees down the front here. You can see what I'm doing. I'm just adding one, and I'm moving it slightly. I'm moving it slightly, but moving it up and away so that they look like, gives a little bit of depth there. And that's that one. The inside, I'm just going to stamp some trees. And the envelope the same, I'm just going to stamp some trees in that bottom corner. And then making sure that that is out of the way. I'll set on the back there. So that's all the stamping done. Close those up so nothing falls in them. And then we will bring my lovely Big Shot, special edition Big Shot in. This, I said it before, if you haven't got a die cutting machine, it just allows you to do so much more with your crafting. So I've got these two frames, and I don't know if you know, but usually there's writing on the frames. I always have them next to each other because I just think it helps me anyway try and line things up. So that's, I'm not measuring it, it's just going to be by eye. A little bit of a twiggle, a swiggle, and run that through. Take that off when we're done with that. And then it's very quickly put this together. Now check that you've got the opening at the right place. Now, I don't know if you spotted one of my earlier, the last video I did, I think, I noticed when I was watching it back and doing the editing, that I'd actually stuck the inside to the wrong bit. I'd stuck it to this bit. Very easily done, so that's that, and then a little bit of glue. So my customers have real trouble with this Tombow glue, it just doesn't work for them. They end up squeezing too hard and then it all comes out and they get in a real sticky mess. Stick that down nicely. Just, I'm doing that on the back so that in case I've got ink, yes, I've got a little bit of ink, so hopefully that won't smudge. And now to get this bit in place, what I do is I stick the oval there and then I add glue to the base and stick that in the right place. There, give it a few minutes and then we can lift that bit up and add the dimensionals, and we're using the little dimensionals and they fit perfectly on this frame. I'm just gonna make sure that I've got these so that you can't actually see them. You do have to take a little bit of care, but because the frame is just about the right size. I just don't want any of it to be visible. Oh, took the backing off. There we go. So let's take these little bits off. I have my ladies, my car classes on Thursday evening and Saturday morning, and there were smaller classes this month because obviously it's the summer and people are going away on holiday, but it meant that I had a bit more time to help everybody. Sometimes when I've got a house full of ladies, as lovely as it is, it gets a little bit hectic. So that's, I think that just gives a really nice little effect. I'm not going to put a sentiment this time on here because I'm not sure when I'm going to use it. So that's that version. That's the one we did in class. And this is another one that I did slightly earlier, just took it further out. So thank you very much for watching. All the details will be on my blog and you'll find a link below. Give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment. I would really love to know what you think, and if there's any special request for any type of technique or card, then let me know.